Hello everyone, welcome to AmWings Academy classes. I am Amit and in this video we shall continue the topic models. In previous video we discussed on what conditions we can use models. So here I am telling some sentences, and according to that sentence you have to identify the condition. So at present I am teaching you. This is the condition of an action, and at present I am doing an action of teaching you. If I say I can teach you, so it is not an action that I am doing at present. It is a condition of my ability, my capability, otherwise my strength. So basically models are used for those conditions which belong to our mood, otherwise our mental, otherwise physical strength. So all those actions which belong to our mentally, physically or emotionally conditions are written with model. So today we shall continue the first topic of model. It is to show ability, otherwise strength. Strength, ability, capability. See, what is strength? It is power of speaker. It is power of speaker. So, when speaker says about himself, otherwise for another person, and talk about his or her strength, such as Monica can beat Tona in boxing. So Mona and Tona are here two persons, and both are boxer. So in the contest of boxing, otherwise in the game of boxing, if we judge the strength of both Monica and Tona, if you want to know the strength of both, power of both in a game, so a person can identify the power of both, otherwise present the power of Monica, otherwise Tona, by the help of model. So in this sentence, Monica, which has a power, otherwise strength, of beating, it is your verb, of beating Tona in boxing. So if Monica can beat Tona in boxing, then Monica has power. Okay, Monica has physical strength. Another sentence, Monica can read a book in both English and Hindi, and then a languages. So here we have Monica as a subject, and here we are talking about Monica's action. It is reading a book, and a book may be read in English and Hindi language. So to read a book, Monica doesn't need a power or strength. Okay, so here in this sentence there is no requirement of any power, any physical strength for reading a book. Then why I use here can? So here can is show the ability of Monica. Monica has mentally strength. Here Monica has mentally strength, and mentally strength is your ability. Any action, any walk that you can do by your knowledge, you can write such type of sentence for your ability. So here can represents to ability. So basically such type of sentence are written to show the strength, ability, otherwise capability of a subject. Now there are some condition, otherwise some strength, some ability, some capability that we have otherwise had in present or past. Okay, so ability otherwise strength otherwise capability. These are the condition which someone have, otherwise someone had. If you have any ability, strength or capability in present tense, it means you have. If any ability, any strength, any capability that you had in past, it is your past tense. Okay, so there are few strength, few ability, few capabilities that we had in our childhood. Such type of ability, capability or strength can be shown by using the models. So to present the ability, capability and strength of in present tense, then we use can model. If it is used in past, otherwise we talk about the past ability, capability or strength, we use could. Okay, so here we have to only identify the clue in the sentence about the tense. If the given sentence is in present tense and there we talk about any ability, any strength, any capability, at some time in such type of sentence we use can. If we talk about the ability, capability and strength in our past tense, then we use could. So this is the condition. So here we have that, such as an old lady who live who lived near my house. Near my house, space, speak, in English. So an old lady who lived near my house, space, speak in English. And I put here two options about modal. It is can or could. And I ask you to choose the correct option. So in this sentence, first of all, you need to identify the tense. If you read the sentence and after who, if you see, so here you have lived. Here lived is main verb, second form. Lived is main verb, second form. And we know that main verb second form is used in past tense. So basically this sentence belongs to past tense. If I continue my reading, then after filling the blanks, I find speak in English. And who speak in English? An old lady. So here we are talking about the ability, otherwise capability of an old lady who can speak, otherwise could speak in English. So what should I use in my answer? Should I use can? Otherwise, should I use could? So what should I use? It depends on the tense of the sentence. The sentence that is given on the board belongs, otherwise is in past tense. So to describe the past ability, past strength or past capability, we use could. So for my answer, I will use could. Have one more sentence. Sunita always gives me a gift on my birthday and that gift I space okay, I have no space further, so I write here. Sunita always gives me a gift on my birthday and that gift I put carelessly anywhere because of its importance. So here we have question and In this question, I write cannot, otherwise could not. So I told you, before writing the answer of the given question, always find the tense in the sentence. So when you read the sentence, you find the word gives. Gives is the main verb, and it is the main verb fifth form. Gives is the main verb, and it is main verb fifth form. It is main verb fifth form, and we know that main verb fifth form we use in present tense. A verb that ends with s letter, otherwise s letter is ended, s letter is added in that particular verb, then such type of verb is your main verb fifth form, and it is always written in present tense. So if the given sentence belongs to present tense, it means we write can in our answer, but the sentence is in negative sense, so I write here cannot. So every model, otherwise any model, can be written in both sense, in positive or negative sense, except need not and dare not. Need not or dare not are models until they are in negative sense, but if you change the sense and write them as a need or dare, they becomes a main verb, they become a main verb, and your answer will be wrong. So except need not and dare not, we can write any model in both sense, in positive or negative sense. So this is the use of our first two models, it can and could. You can say can or cannot, you can say could or could not. Okay, and today we discuss about the first rule, ability, strength and capability. Thank you.